they were a long way from the dream which I used to talk about then of being able to take a wallet out of my pocket and perhaps open the wallet, press a button, close the wallet, and have the picture.
That's where it all started for me. My first Polaroid. This magical, beautiful little box that spits out gold. But where did it all start? And how was a three-year-old little girl the catalyst for this crazy magical invention? Well, it all started with this guy, Edwin Land.
See them tumbling down, pledging their love to the ground.
In 1944, Land took his three-year-old daughter on a vacation to New Mexico. While out exploring the city of Santa Fe, Land took a photo of his daughter, at which point she asked the crucial question, "Why can't I see the picture now?" Land thought to himself, "That's a great fucking question, kid." He went on a walk later that evening, contemplating, and according to legend, within an hour he came up with the idea for the SX-70. And though it would be 25 years before it came to fruition, he laid out his plans, met with his patent lawyer, and began the first steps towards what would become Polaroid Instant Film. 3 years later, the first Land camera was introduced. The Model 95.
Range I belong, drifting along with a tumbling tumbleweed.
This was quickly followed by a series of other models. And by the mid-1960s, Polaroid had blown the fuck up.
Here's our number one executive kit. As you can see, it's all packed in an attaché case. It holds the camera and flash, portrait kit, self-timer, developing timer, black and white film, color film, cable release, and 24 flash bulbs.
Polaroid announces an economy model of the famous color pack camera. For half the price of the original. Same great film. Same fast loading. Same electric eye. You get the same beautiful color prints in 60 seconds. Black and white in 10 seconds. In the same big size. Yet Polaroid is figuring out a way to bring it out for only half the price of the original model.
By the early 1970s, the SX-70 finally arrived. And it was everything it had ever promised it would be. Collapsible, capable, portable, fully manual, for the consumer as well as the professional. It was a work of scientific and creative wonder.
The exposed film out of the camera is now protected by the turquoise opacifier, which also carries the processing ingredients. The film is about 1/100 of an inch thick. 2/3 of this is the transparent film cover and the black backing.
Proof of not only Edwin Land's vision, but that with imagination, dreams can come true.
The camera is the factory. The factory is the camera. I look forward to the time a few years from now when you come here to share with us the excitement and deep satisfaction of seeing all this in operation and at the same time starting to use our long-awaited ultimate camera that is a part of the evolving human being.
Enthusiasm and vision are two very different things. Enthusiasm can be lost. It can fade. Vision is forever. With Land gone, the vision behind Polaroid was also gone. And no matter the enthusiasm remaining at Polaroid, no doubt, without vision, to continue was impossible.
If you're not taking color pictures with the new Polaroid Color Pack camera, there's something left out of your life.
Enter Florian Dogcaps. To make a long story short, along came Save Polaroid, and then simultaneously coming over from Europe, Pola Premium. Florian Dogcaps was the man behind Pola Premium. They took all the remaining stock, they bought out the machines, they whatever they could get their hands on. Of course, Polaroid had already lost some essential components, like the access to certain chemicals and certain components was gone forever. But Doc Caps had vision. So vision came back to the fold. With Pola Premium came the Impossible Project. With the success of the Impossible Project came Polaroid Originals. With the success of Polaroid Originals, we are now back in the land of Polaroid. Along the way, there were offshoots of instant film. And there was Fuji FP100C, which was peel-apart instant film, which you could buy a 10-pack of for 10 bucks. And then when that got discontinued, that immediately skyrocketed in price. Now it costs anywhere from $75 to $90 to $200 for a pack or two of Fuji FP100C. By the way, side note, for all you people who are hoarding the Fuji FP100C,
give me back my son!
Who have it where it's just going to sit and rot forever because no one's going to pay $300 for 10 shots of FP100C. And who's saving peel apart instant film? Same guy. Cap's current company, SuperSense, is now the producer and distributor of One Instant, which is a new peel apart film. It's still a little pricey, definitely not in my budget, but it's a step in the right direction. It's a promise that we'll get there. It's the same promise that Impossible brought, that led to Polaroid Originals, that led to back to Polaroid.
What I love about this camera is that it allows you to capture the moment. Every moment in life that you stop and show this happened just then and here. All those moments are the precious moments. And because the Polaroid sonar one step focuses itself with sound waves, you can capture the moments you might have missed. And those are the moments we want to keep and remember.
But the bottom line here is, we're never going to lose instant film altogether, because even in its demise, people were figuring out ways to make instant film work. Mint came along, they started producing instant film cameras. And then individuals started to create them. You know, there's a guy out there creating Instax backs for the RZ67. I picked up one of these 3D printed Instax backs for my RB67, and that was produced by an outfit called Coyote Camera Works down in Mexico, which I'm pretty sure is just a small mom and pop's operation. Now, if you came into the narrative of the Polaroid story, it would almost seem as though nothing ever happened, that it just consistently continued on. There's always going to be some evidence of Impossible Project. And the way that you can always kind of recognize this is when you look at the casing that holds the film of a Polaroid pack and you flip it over, you still have the stamp of the Impossible Project on there, like a birthmark. Just to remind you that a phoenix rises from the ashes. So the lesson is this: with vision, that which seems impossible can be rectified in almost an instant.